Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Parent and Caregiver Corner. As you know, these four sessions are going to review the four components of how does learning happen. So this is a resource that we at the Early On Center utilize to support the way in which we provide early learning experiences for you and your children. As the document reads, curriculum, which is learning content, and pedagogy, which is how learning happens in early year settings, are shaped by the views of children, the role of educators and families, and relationships among them. This document, How Does Learning Happen, helps us educators focus on these connections within early years environments. There are four components that we incorporate into our planning: belonging, which is what we did last week, well-being, which will be this week, and then engagement and expression. So let's talk about well-being. We want to ensure that children have healthy patterns of eating, physical activity, and sleep. We also want them to understand how to self-care, have a sense of self, and know how to self-regulate. Part of that self-care comes from a parent's mindfulness and ability to model well-being. So our pedagogy would encourage you to ensure that there are opportunities and time to teach your children self-help and self-care skills based on their capabilities. This can be done throughout daily routines and activities. And as mentioned, an important component of teaching your children these skills is actually practicing them yourself. And so your ability to practice mindfulness when spending time with your child or children in turn will allow you to support their well-being by being responsive to their needs and various stressors. So here's a list of things to try. Number one, create a feeding routine. And remember that your children are capable of knowing when they are hungry and when they are full. Eventually, they will adjust to having a feeding schedule, but at first, try not to force your child to eat at any given time. Know that they know their body best and respect their ability to self-nourish. Number two, practice your own self-care. What makes you feel good? Perhaps a yoga class, maybe time for a bath or a walk outside. I've attached a link in the description for a YouTube channel with loads of free yoga. See if you can fit in a 30-minute class from time to time. And number three, finally, teach your children about breathing. So slowing down our breath in times of stress is a great way to regulate our emotions and bring our stress levels down. If these skills are taught when our children are calm, they'll have it in their back pocket for moments of distress. I've attached a snowman breathing activity to try out with your children. I have one printed here. So you have this lovely little snowman with four buttons on it. And essentially you'll just sit with your child and help them point to each button. And with each button, they're going to take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. So they might go one, and so on and so forth. And then perhaps once it does start snowing and you're making snowmans together, in that activity alone, you can start practicing deep breathing. So leave a comment below to share ideas on what you like to do for self-care and what you like to do to support your child's well-being. That's it for today. Next week, we will discuss engagement, so I will talk to you then.